Assalamu alaikum, I'm Fauzia Qureshi. I'm an architect by profession. Currently, I'm heading the Department of Architecture of the National College of Arts. I've been in practice for the last 25 years, since 1976, and I have to my credit number of buildings. Primarily, most of the buildings that I've designed are institutional buildings, buildings that whose users are large numbers of people, not necessarily individual families. By and large, most of the buildings that I've been designing, which range from SOS villages to school buildings, college buildings, and so on, deal with large numbers of people interacting within it. By and large, my concept of design has been that the buildings should be maintenance-free and that they should be comfortable, such that the buildings welcome people and the people also feel comfortable within the premises. The project that we are standing in front of is one of my projects that was completed in 1998. It is known as the Asar Resource Center, an Institute of Women's Studies. It's primarily an NGO dealing with women's issues. The project comprises of essentially three distinct areas. One is the office space of the NGO itself. The other is the training institute part of it, which is dealt with by the Institute of Women's Studies. And the third area is the residential part of this organization, which comprises primarily a hostel building. I'd like you to come and visit the place. The site of the Asar Resource Center comprises less than four canals. The built-up area that and the requirements that were given to me by the client amounted to over 17,000 square foot of built-up area. Keeping the building regulations in view, in which we were not allowed to go beyond 38 feet height, the result was that we had to go one into the basement, and secondly, the building above had to be designed in a manner where we could maximize our built-up area, and the plan was designed in a manner where we had open spaces all around outside. Care was taken because it was a pretty well wooded site. The intent was not to cut any of the trees from within the site, and therefore there were open spaces, essentially really strips of land that were left outside, but with adequate views on the outside, and an inward looking courtyard where we are currently standing. This courtyard is at the ground level, and from the ground level you can see below there is the basement level, which opens onto the ground level. It is almost like a sub-basement, and therefore it houses the library, which is very well lit, not only from the light that comes in from this courtyard, but also from light which is there on from the outside, which we will see later. All the rooms within this office building where we are standing, as well as the institute building where the classes for the Women's Studies Institute are held, look into this central courtyard, and you can see that the windows have been placed such that they all look into each other, the entire concept being that the building users should be interactive, that there is interaction between each space, whichever floor it may be on. Moreover, the building has been designed in a manner where different levels have been created. Like I was mentioning, because of the tight nature of the site, care has been taken that, and because we had to build vertically, care has been taken that the different levels are not at a very great height. So the building has been designed in levels such that each floor is just about 5 feet above the next floor, and therefore, like you can see, I've just had to climb up 5 feet and I'm at one level, and then as I move up to the next level, that's another 5 feet. So the entire building has been designed on a 5 feet floor to ceiling height. Like I mentioned earlier, the concept has been that the place, all the spaces that have been designed are visible, each room is visible to the other room. In other words, it's a user-friendly space. No personnel is working independently. He or she does have the option of being visually related to the next room or to the next person. It's been essentially been designed as an open plan office. The materials that have been used not only in the exterior but also in the interior have been low cost materials. The objective was to bring the cost of the project down to as little as possible. This building was essentially completed in about 550 rupees per square foot. The furniture that you can probably see in some of the shots has been built of essentially laminated board, which is a very low cost material. The furniture has been designed again as a modular furniture so that the furniture can be moved around and be treated in whichever way that the institute at its various times can adapt the furniture according to its requirements. The view that I had mentioned earlier where the spaces are interactive can possibly be seen here in this area, where we are standing at about 10 feet above ground level, and you can see the floor below, which is at about 5 feet at about 5 feet, and another floor above, which is at plus 15 feet. So the whole concept has been primarily that the spaces are all interrelated they are user friendly. Apart from the fact that the building has been designed on low cost in the interior finishes, which includes basically essentially white terrazzo cement floors, but added to that is a bit of color by using decorative inlay marble on the floors at a minimum, so as not to enhance the value, not to enhance the cost of construction, and yet adding a flair to the building. The exterior of the building again has been designed as a maintenance-free building using brick. The walls have been designed as 9-inch structural walls with a 4.5-inch wall with a cavity in between to ensure that the interior of the building is thermally well protected from the exterior harsh climate of Lahore. Essentially, it is a very tight site, as you can see from here. It had a very narrow frontage and a very deep depth of the plot. There was an existing building which was here, which was a ground floor building built already, and this was like the lawn of this original building. It was in this lawn that we constructed the Asr Resource Center and the IWSL offices and the institutional building. The rear was left as the hostel area. In the front, the access to the plot was also through a very narrow 16 feet wide lane, and we come up and there was a little bit of parking provided here as well as here. The entrance lobby was provided, and then the entire building was divided into two areas. There was the lower ground floor or the basement area on this side and the ground floor area on this. So you entered from the ground level and you went down into the basement area where there was the library and the computer facilities and so on, which had an access from the rear for the resident students to enter in, go down and enter into the library or the computer area. There was a flight of stairs provided at the rear from where the students, when they came in from here, they could climb up and go up to the institutional, their classrooms and so on. This entrance area dealt primarily with the spaces which were the administration and the day-to-day running of the Asr, which is the NGO resource center. There was the accounts area, the admin area provided right on the ground floor. There was Asr is involved with a lot of publications, so a bookshop was provided right up front in the front. And if we can go on to the next floor plan, I'll continue to explain this further. This is what one would refer to as the mid-level plan. This is the lower area with the access from the residential area into the first smaller seminar room and the faculty room. So the faculty and the students had a direct link to the hostel facilities at the back. The front of these facilities were again part of the ASR Resource Center with the director's room, the conference room, the coordinator's room and the program officers who were running the various programs of ASR located in the front of this building. And there was of course this faculty area. This faculty and the students who are now using the lower library facilities, the seminar room and the faculty room could go further up onto the next floor, which I will now show you on this plan. They climb up here and we have again more faculty room, a scholars in resident and scholars room and the seminar room. Now this plan also shows that these are two separate levels and each level has a terrace attached to it. The whole objective being that each office space has an open terrace space available, and more so for the students and the faculty and those involved in the seminar room, so that during the time of their seminars they can come out for their tea break onto this terrace or this terrace. The scholar or the in residence has a private terrace to herself and where she can work on in privacy and on her own. And as we go behind here, right here, we have what is known as the residential area. This building, this part of the building was originally built up and it was essentially renovated and built up as a hostel building. The original porch was converted into a veranda of sort of a space where the students could sit and look into the lawn here. There was the lounge and dining facility and an open plan kitchen that was provided for the in-residents to have their breakfast, lunch and dinner. And then there were the various double-seater rooms, and the furniture was designed in a manner where the rooms could be converted into single bedrooms, double bedrooms and go all the way up to three bedrooms. So the concept was that if we have a bedroom here, there were some bedrooms which had an attached toilet. On the first floor of this of the hostel building, there was a flight of stairs going up and there were again room. This was the part that was developed as an extension to the already existing ground floor. There are the rooms and then there were the common toilet facilities with shower cubicles, WCs and so on that were provided. Care was also taken to provide lots of storage space, because the being hostels, we needed to have spaces where we could keep their laundry, their towels and their bed sheets and so on. So a lot of storage space was also provided. There was a space at the back which was developed as a faculty lounge and a faculty bedroom area. A faculty kitchenette, dining space, a lounge space with a bed space was also provided. This area was also provided with a direct access from the outside to come in and the flight of stairs going up, so that the faculty has the option of having their relative privacy.